Alright, so here I am again. I am just in the perplexion of the Apaches and the Comanches down there having revolts and then being put into reservations, that time frame. Okay, so what I've been learning now, differences, there are some major differences that I'm seeing with the Comanches versus the Apaches. Right away, they give online quite a bit that the Comanches at that time were very, very get up and go. And when I mean get up and go, I mean like 20 minutes they could pack their teepees, their camp, their horses, and move the entire camp away to another locale. So they were quick, they were the fast. That's what it is portraying, that they were super fast, the schnell. And then you see the Apaches, and it's almost like the opposite. You have the pottery, they're making pottery, they're very much more substantialized in place, not get up and go. And yes, there's the accusation that Comanches were the horse thieves of the other Indians. They would go steal at the other Indians, and possibly from the Apaches also. They would steal their horses. So yeah, Comanches are not known for being, what do you say? They couldn't stay away from the horses. They like them. All right. Now, with all of these tribes here that I'm reading about, the Navajo, the Apaches, they are practicing, the Comanches also. I actually didn't get a mention on the Comanches, but they're yes, I have a beautiful hat this evening. They are practicing a different type of marriage. Their marriage includes, it's called sororate. Like sorority, sororate. Now this is when the husband marries and he also gets the sister. Okay? So you can have your little wonderful Indian and yet, well, your sister is also included in the party. Okay? She will be there as part of the marriage banquet. So it's a polygamy situation. So they were polygamists. Interesting. Now they also had another thing going on, which is the, I'll try to do the quick pop-up of this. It's called levirate. The levirate marriage is when, as soon as, let's say, the brother, a brother died in the tribe, the other brother took over and married that wife instantly. So you had that wife was never left as a, what is the term? She was never left as on her own. She always had a husband. Okay, so there was always that, there was never like a drop of a woman off into outer space like they do here in this America. All the time, you know, and England and France, you know, this is like the new thing is, oh, there's a woman, just drop her off into outer space, you know. Okay, so any hoot. So this is very, very interesting. So they never really drop the woman. They're always caring for her, attending for her. She is part of that tribe, and she is never estranged in, like they do in these modern times. So interesting though. So they marry the one woman, and then they also marry the sister. They get her also. So I guess it's the way it goes, because you know, oftentimes you have the beautiful woman and then you have the sister, and it's like, well, somebody has to marry the sister. So anyway, and then here we have also the Apaches, more stabilized, with the, making massive pots, carrying them on their heads, And here are these Comanches. They don't have time for that. They had time to use the buffalo hides, 14 buffalo hides, so 22 per teepee. And this was all done by the women. They'd lay them out into the hot sun. They would skin them. They'd skin the hides off. They would put water out on them, and they would get more and more things. The fur gone, and so eventually they just end up with a hide. And then they would sew. Then they would sew those ten them together, you know, with a special little cogs, I guess is the terminology. They were like little pegs. But yeah, so then they would use those, and then 20 minutes it would be the call, and they are on the go. The women packed up those teepees. So there was no time. There was no time for the luxury of art, was there? Not really. Not in that instance. There's no time for the luxury of, hey, you know, we're making our pots here. So we're really talking a different group. You know, very, very different. You know, just in that alone. Because it's like, well, no. You know, I don't want to leave my things. I don't want to leave my possessions. You know. And then there's the other, you know, that didn't even acquire the possessions in the first place. He just said, no, I'm not going to. I'm going to be ready to go. I have my horses, and it's much funner. It's much funner to get on those horses. They would go, and apparently still, they've, you know, 200 and 300 horses from another neighboring tribe. And yeah, so they had all of that going on, where they were just, what do you call it, infused in adoration, love. They just adored the horses. And so they were theirs, you know. So maybe that's just the way it went, you know, they were theirs. So, and unfortunately, I'm finding with the Comanches, I'm not finding very good images online. I'm not finding good photos. They are really the wildest and the most rebel that I can come up with so far out of this Indian group. You know, to just be able to take 20 minutes and that's it, and you're out. You've got your house and you're gone, and with the horses from down the way, somebody else's tribe, you're gone, you know, just like lightning, you know, they're just like lightning, fast. And when you see their artwork, it is incredible. It is incredible. They are in pursuit of other Indians, and they lance them with long, long poles. They absolutely lance them. So they were doing this, you know, remember in the Dandriada, old England, you know, they used to do this. They used to do the charging of the lances, horse to horse, you know, all of that. The Renaissance era, and then try to get each other off the horse. But these guys would go behind, the Comanches would go behind, and then lance, get that guy as he was trying to run away. And then there it is, another one, another horse. So yeah, they were loving horses. and it's just incredible when you think about it. So they were really mobile. They were the mobile ones. And when I'm thinking about Apaches now, because I've been to Mescalero many times, I've driven through it, I know it, and it's just like, well, I didn't really see anything, just kind of, you know, and I'm not in this modern time, am I? I'm just not. It's almost like you see better when you even envision the past, and imagine the past. It's almost like you witness history better in your head. Than even visiting the now today Indians, because so much has gone on since, you know, that it's just it's not the same credible group they're not the same credible factor, you know, they're not working under the same conditions, you know, they've been suppressed, and it's just changed the ball game. But I will say this, the Apache women can be gorgeous. There are some gorgeous ones, very beautiful. So I don't know. I'm still up in a furor. Which one am I? I'm leaning towards the Apache, just because I don't think I have horse thievery in my veins. I'm not a good thief. I'm not. I've never stolen from a store. I've never been able to. You know, I can't handle it. It just freaks me out. So, when it comes to horse thievery, you know, that's serious. You know, if I go around and start claiming myself as Comanche, you're going to think I'm going to start stealing your car, you know. Maybe they are the best car thieves, though. They could very well be the best car thieves in this United States of America. So maybe better not to even claim yourself as Comanche at all. Maybe better to say, just claim yourself as, just as a person, U.S. Anyway, yeah, so I have some really fun hats. These are, what is this one? This one is a real queen hat, isn't it? Oh my gosh. Yeah. So anyway, so it's kind of nice though. In a way, I feel kind of warm and fuzzy about the whole thing, because even if I was born as the ugly sister, I would still have a husband, you know? And I kind of just adore that. I adore that. I think that's wonderful. Yeah. Anyway. Andrea. So this hat tonight is, I don't know, I think my mother was on like an orbital trip at the time. Things have to orbit. This one's working for me. I think it's okay. All right, well, that's all I have. I wish I knew more of the past. These little Wikipedia snippets are not the be-all and end-all. Not at all. And gee whiz. Gee whiz. Did I do anything fun today on my Indian 6%? Well, I planted a bunch. That's all. I just planted a bunch in the hot, hot sun in the middle of the day. I probably shouldn't have, but I did that anyway. And I'm starting to feel more invigorated with sit-ups again. So all of this talk about 20 minutes of getting up and going, I decided to do sit-ups. But I don't think I'm Comanche. I just don't think it. Yeah. Because I don't have a fanaticism for vehicles. You know? I don't really care about them at all. I don't care if they're good. I don't care if they're bad. And I sure as heck don't want to steal them. But then maybe it doesn't go from horse to car. You know, maybe it really is the animal. You know, maybe they just wanted the animals. You know, maybe the car thing just didn't traverse into modern times. So it's very possible the Comanches just, what fun is life now? You know, we can't even steal horses. What fun is life now? Because who the heck wants cars? You can't feed them, you can't talk to them, they're not your friend, they don't just go when you want, you know, you have to give gas to those other things. there's no like friend attachment, there's no association attachment, there's no get up and jump on it. You know, none of that is going on. None. So maybe I'm seeing a vapant miss by the replacement of the automobiles. Yeah, because who would want to steal those? Yuck. Yeah, horses are superior. Absolutely superior. All right. I don't know. I kind of want to leave a little image out there. There's a few. Gosh, they owned this land, didn't they? They just owned so much of it. Just all over the place. And I can't believe how quickly the white man just showed up and took over. I just cannot believe it to this day. Just zoomed in on their steamships and just took over. It's just incredible, actually. Because of the advent of the gun. Yeah, the gun and gunpowder. So I don't know what to do on my front image here. Should I leave you with the Apache bride? She's kind of interesting. She has big eyes. And then there's a little boy, and he's carrying a big, massive pot on his head. And I have seen that pot that he has on his head. I have seen it in the desert, in broken pieces. I have seen that in the upper desert, I will say, up closer to the Ruidoso Mountains. I went on a trip there with my great aunt, and we went hunting for Indian pottery, and it was all along a hillside, and we would pick up all the little pieces, and they were, you know, painted. I don't know where what happened to them. We picked them up, of course, and lost them since. But yeah, that's what happens. And yeah, it was the black. It was the black, and it was just like this one that this little boy is carrying on his head, where it has the crisscross, where it goes the black, the white, the black, the white, the black, the white, like the checkerboard pattern. So it's very interesting. Very interesting to see the checkerboard pattern. There were other ones that were more intricate, but they're gone. Yes, there I was, you know, a naughty little kid up there with my great aunt and my cousins, or second cousins, and we're snatching these things, you know, taking them back to the house. I found, an arrowhead, you know, and, you know, a handful of pottery, and gone. It's gone now. You know, all the life, all the years, all those things are gone. So, yeah. Anyway, I'll leave that little pottery, because he is a sweetheart. Alrighty. So, yeah, Apaches are stability monsters, I'm going to call you. Stability monsters and the get up and go of the Comanches. But yeah, maybe only get up and go when they had the horses. So everything has changed, hasn't it?